Hello, in this video, we will show how to display frequency and contingency tables using rprogramming. So we know a frequency table will list a set of values and how often, counts for each values. And in R, these tables will help you understand how often some values for specific variables occur, and a contingency table, which means a two-way for two-variable frequency table. And R provides several methods for creating frequency and contingency tables, and the functions also used to add margins, for example, or calculate proportions. So basically, this function table with the variable belonging to data frame, this is the basic function, can create one variable or two variable or more than two variables. And xtab is also a similar function like table, but it uses the formula like with a tilde symbol and with a variable where you want to create counts from. Then plot table and the margin table and add margins, these three functions will apply on the objects created from table and xtable functions. And ftable is another function for create frequencies. So next we will show one by one and in RStudio. So for example, using table for calculate the improved variables, values count, then we use plop.table to calculate the proportions. So first, we load a library called VCD because this data frame called rdatacode comes with library VCD. So you have to install VCD if the package is not shown. So you can see this dataset has 5 columns ID treatment and the sex, age, and improved. Then we can calculate a very simple counts using table function for the improved variable. Then we can show this table. So improved value has 3 non, sum, and marked, and their counts are 42, 14, and 28. Then based on this object, can use plop.table to calculate the proportions. So it's quite clear, the proportion is just the count divided by the total count. Then we can also create with the percent by multiplying 100 over the proportion table. So this is the percent of each variable. So you can use alternative way with xtabs function with a tilde symbol, then treatment plus improved. You know, this kind of form is called R formula, R framework form. So R always use tilde symbol in regression also, for example. And we add a data equals rdatacode. Then this object is also created. Then we show. So this is a contingency table for two variables, treatment and improved. Their values are 2 rows by 3 columns for different combinations and their corresponding counts. So based on this contingency table, we can add margin using the margin table to calculate the margin value. We add 1 here, 1 is for row, So treatment variable is in row. So treatment, the two values will be calculated with the margin value. Actually, is the sum of this row and the sum of the second row. You can also calculate with the proportion of a contingency table. So this proportion will show the proportions by row, because we add option one here. So proportion is each table's value, count value divided by the row sum. Similarly, we can calculate the margin value by column. So we add a 2 here. 2 means column. So this means the improved value for the column, for the marginal value, are calculated. And we can also calculate the proportion by column. So there are column proportions. So each field represents the proportions of the corresponding count values in the original my table object divided by the column sum for this column. So if we just run the proportion table for this X table, it will show the cell proportions for the total counts. So this proportion means this cell value from the table, from the contingency table, by the total divided by the total counts in the contingency tables, right? So divided by the old observations here. If we add margins using add margins of this table function, then the row sum and the column sum and the total sum will be added. Similarly, we can add margin over the proportion table. So you can see the proportions. These proportions means the proportion is the cell counts in original table contingency table divided by the total counts. Then row sum by it, then divided by the row sum and divided by it. Then add with the row sum for this proportion and the column sum for this proportion and the total sum for the proportion. Of course, this is 1. You can also add row margins or add column margins for contingency table. So first we create add 1 here, then 2 outside of these parentheses. Then this means the proportion table calculated by row and add a margin by column. So this means add a margin by column and calculated by row for the proportion. And alternatively, we can calculate the proportion by column, then add a margin by row for the proportion. Another function from G models called cross table. This function will show the results quite similar as in SPSS and SAS function. So if you have used SPSS or SAS, they are quite similar. And each table has several parts. Each part will have several rows. These 5 rows means counts and chi-square contribution, and divided by row total, divided by the column total, and divided by the table total for these 5 rows. So each field has 5 rows, of course, with the margin for row and column. if you have time, you can investigate a little further this function. So next, we will show three-way table, three variables, treatment, sex, and improved from the same data frame if we use xtabs function. So the result shows by each improved value, because improved is the third value. So by each value of improved variable, there is a two-way contingency table between treatment and sex. Then we can add a margin. Then we can calculate the margin value for treatment. Second variable for sex, how many counts, and for improved variable. Then you can also calculate the total by two variable. So here we add C13 means treatment by improved. Actually, this is a two-way contingency table. So next function called ftable. If we use ftable run on the myTable function, myTable comes from xtabs object, right? But this is a three-way table, so we also can show further with the ftable function. So ftable will list the third column by each value, then on the row we'll show the combination of the first two variables. So like treatment placebo, female, placebo, male, treatment female, treatment male, then with each observations of improved variable. The next function we can use cross table of this myTable object, then with the ftable, and we add a C12. So this means proportion sum to 1 over the index omitted. So which means this will calculate the proportions and sum to 1 by over the value of improved, because we did not add 3 here. 3 means improved variable. So which means this row sum will be 1. Over this row will be 1. And similarly, we calculate proper table, then add margin with 3, calculate the row proportions over the rows, over these rows, then add a margin on this column. So row margin on this column. Then we can also times 100, show the percent. So we have shown most of the table-related function for generating frequency or contingency tables by one variable, two variable, and more than two variables in R. So usually, the basic function we have seen based on the table function and based on xtable function. So table function and xtable function are basic. Then we create object. Then based on these two kinds of object, we can add margin, then I can calculate the proper table proportion or calculate the margin value. You can also use the cross table function to calculate the same, very similar result as in SAS and SPSS. If you want, you can download the source files from this GitHub link for our video playlist for the statistics using R programming. Most of the videos will be uploaded later, and all source files can be found in this R file. Thanks for watching.